Hello, dear students. So now today we would move ahead in this first chapter of class 12 chemistry, that is solid state. So as we have discussed in the previous video, so there we have discussed if you have the particles at the corner, then the contribution of the particle to each corner would be how much? 1/8, that we have discussed there. Okay, so let's say you have the particle at corner. Okay, how many corners are there? 8. Now, if you have the particle at the corner, just now I have shown to you also. Let's say you have the particle at the corner, this one corner. Okay, let's say you have the particle at this one corner. So it would be joining with other unit cells also. So the contribution of this one particle to each unit cell would be how much? Would be how much? 1/8, isn't it? That we have discussed. So I am going to write here contribution. So contribution of the particle towards each unit cell would be how much? 8. So we have 8 corners there. Now if let's say the particle is at the edge, you have the particle over the edge there, isn't it? Now if other unit cells are joining with it, okay, so the contribution of the particle which is there over the edge would be how much to each unit cell? So the contribution of the particle which is there on the edge here, which is there on the edge, so contribution of that one particle to each unit cell would be how much? 1/4, isn't it? 1/4. Similarly, if you have the particle on the faces there, let's say you have the particle on this one face, so it would be joining with one more unit cell. So the contribution of that one particle would be 1/2 to this one unit cell, 1/2 to other unit cell, isn't it? So you have how many faces total? 6 faces. So contribution of the particle to each unit cell would be how much? 1/2, isn't it? Similarly, if the particles are at the body center which is there inside at the middle, so you have one body center, so contribution of the particle to each unit cell would be 1, because the particle is related to only to this one unit cell, so it would be contributing towards only this unit cell, so its contribution would be how much? 1. Now let's say you have the particle in the body diagonals. Now you have 4 body diagonals, one from here to here, isn't it? One from here to here, other from here to here, then one from here to here, then one from here to here. So this is how you have 4 body diagonals. Mean joining this one corner and that one corner. So just draw the line from inside. So you would have one diagonal here, one diagonal this one side, one diagonal this one side, and one diagonal this one side. So you would be getting 4 diagonals there, body diagonals. So if the particle is there at the body diagonal there, any body diagonal there, so its a contribution would be towards only this one unit cell, because if it is joining with other unit cell, because it is inside there, isn't it? So it would be contributing only towards this one unit cell. So its contribution would be how much? 1, isn't it? Because it is contributing towards only one unit cell, isn't it? So this is how we would find out the contribution. Okay, now on the basis of this, we are to find out the rank of the cell, or we can say the number of particles in a unit cell. Okay, in a unit cell, how many particles are there? That we also know, that we also call as the rank of the cell. So how do you find out? Okay, so let me write here types of cell, unit cell means, okay, types of unit cell, that I am writing here, types of unit cell. Then here I am writing its rank. Rank means the number of particles represented by J. Let's say we have the simple unit cell. Simple unit cell means primitive unit cell. So you are knowing in case of the primitive unit cell, the particles are there only at the corners, isn't it? Only at the corners. So how many corners are there? 8 corners are there. And in case of corners, the contribution of the particle to each unit cell is how much? 1/8. So I am going to multiply it by 1/8. So I would have the rank as 1. So in case of the simple unit cell, the rank of the cell is 1. So there would be only 1 particle there. Number of particles are 1 in case of the simple unit cell. Now if you have the cell as face centered cubical unit cell, FCC I am writing here. Face centered cubical unit cell, isn't it? So if you have face centered cell or face centered cubical unit cell, so in case of the face centered, you have the particles at where? We have already discussed in that one case, in case of while we are discussing the types of cells. Okay, so there you have discussed in case of the face centered unit cells. So the total lattice points we have discussed. So particles are where? Particles are at corners also, and plus particles are faces also. How many corners are there? 8 corners there. Contribution of the particle would be वन बाय एट. हाउ मेनी फेसेस आर देयर? सिक्स. कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल वुड बी वन बाय टू. सो इफ यू आर जस्ट सॉल्विंग इट, सो इट वेटिंग वन प्लस थ्री, वन जा थ्री, आंसर वुड बी फोर. सो इन केस ऑफ द फेस सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल, द रैंक ऑफ द सेल वुड बी हाउ मच? फोर. इजंट इट? फोर. नाउ लेट्स से यू हैव बॉडी सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल. बॉडी सेंटर्ड सेल, बॉडी सेंटर्ड क्यूबिकल यूनिट सेल, व्हाटएवर यू कॉल, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस. ओके, सो इन केस ऑफ द बॉडी सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल, वेयर आर द पार्टिकल्स? द पार्टिकल्स आर एट कॉर्नर्स प्लस बॉडी सेंटर. इजंट इट? वी हैव डिस्कस दिस. ओके, सो हाउ मेनी कॉर्नर्स डू यू हैव? एट कॉर्नर्स. कंट्रीब्यूशन इज हाउ मच? वन बाय एट. सिमिलरली हाउ मेनी बॉडी सेंटर्स आर देयर? वन. कंट्रीब्यूशन इज अगेन वन, देयर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय वन. इजंट इट? सो इफ यू आर जस्ट सॉल्विंग दिस, हाउ मच यू आर गेटिंग? टू. सो रैंक ऑफ द सेल वुड बी टू. इजंट इट? सो नाउ सेल, नाउ इफ यू हैव द पार्ट, इफ यू हैव द सेल एज एंड फेस सेंटर्ड सेल, एंड फेस सेंटर्ड सेल, सो वेयर आर द पार्टिकल्स हियर? पार्टिकल्स आर एट कॉर्नर्स प्लस टू अपोजिट फेसेस, मीन्स टू फेसेस. ओके, सो इन केस ऑफ कॉर्नर्स देर आर एट कॉर्नर्स, कंट्रीब्यूशन इज वन बाय एट. सिमिलरली इन केस ऑफ द फेसेज, हाउ मेनी फेसेज आर देयर? ओनली टू फेसेज यू आर गोइंग टू टेक, अपोजिट फेसेज देयर. ओके, सो टू फेसेज एंड कंट्रीब्यूशन इज वन बाय टू. सो यू वुड बी गेटिंग द रैंक एज हाउ मच? टू. सो टू वुड बी द रैंक इन केस ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स, इफ द पार्टिकल्स, इफ द टाइप ऑफ सेल इज एंड फेस सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल. सो इफ यू हैव एंड फेस सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल, सो इन दैट केस यू हैव टू पार्टिकल्स आर देयर. ओके, और यू कैन से द रैंक ऑफ द सेल इज टू. रैंक ऑफ एंड फेस सेंटर्ड सेल इज टू. इजंट इट? सो होप यू आर गेटिंग दिस. ओके, नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड. सो हेयर अगेन वी विल बी टेकिंग सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स. लेट्स से यू हैव अ यूनिट सेल, जस्ट नोट इट डाउन बिफोर दिस. ओके, नाउ लेट मी मूव अहेड. नाउ लेट्स से यू हैव अ यूनिट सेल वेयर द पार्टिकल्स आर, लेट्स से एट द कॉर्नर्स. ओके, यू हैव अ टाइप ऑफ सेल. ओके, सो इन दैट वन सेल यू हैव द पार्टिकल्स एट, यू हैव द पार्टिकल्स एट कॉर्नर्स. ओके, यू हैव अ सेल वेयर द पार्टिकल्स आर देयर एट कॉर्नर्स एंड वेयर द पार्टिकल्स आर देयर एट फेस सेंटर्स एंड वेयर द पार्टिकल्स आर देयर एट बॉडी सेंटर्स ऑल्सो. ओके, मीन्स यू हैव अ सेल, सो इन दैट वन सेल यू हैव पार्टिकल्स एट कॉर्नर्स, फेस सेंटर्स एंड बॉडी सेंटर. सो वॉट वुड बी द रैंक ऑफ दिस वन सेल? इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द रैंक ऑफ दिस वन सेल, सो हाउ डू यू फाइंड आउट द रैंक ऑफ दिस वन सेल? इफ यू सी कॉर्नर्स, हाउ मेनी कॉर्नर्स आर देर? टोटल एट. कंट्रीब्यूशन इज वन बाय एट. सिमिलरली फेस सेंटर, हाउ मेनी फेसेज आर देयर? सिक्स. कंट्रीब्यूशन वुड बी इन केस ऑफ फेस वन बाय टू. Isn't it? Similarly, you have body centers. How many body centers are there? Only one. Contribution is again one there. So if you are solving it, you would be getting how much? 3 plus 1 plus 4, 5. 4 plus 1, 5. So in that case, the rank of such cell would be how much? 5. Now let's say you have to find out the molecular formula now. Molecular formula of a compound. Okay. So how do you find out the molecular formula? Let's say you have a cell. Let's say you have a particle A. Let's say you have a particle A. And this one particle is present at the corners. Okay. And you have particle B there. You have particle B there. And the particle B present at the face center. On the face centers. Okay. Means you have two types of particle are there. A type particle are present at the corners and B type particles are present on the faces there. Okay. So in that one case, you have to find out the molecular formula of such compound. Okay. What would be the molecular formula? Now, if you see, if the particles are at the corners, A particle are at the corner. So how many corners are there total? 8, and contribution is 8. So you would be getting rank of A as 1. Means you would be getting A particles as how many there? A particles are only 1. Okay, similarly, if you count to count out B particles, how many B type particles are there? But B type particles are there at the face centers. You have 6 faces and contribution in case of face center, you have 1 by 2. So you'll be getting 3. Okay, are you getting? Now you have to find out the molecular formula. So to find out the molecular formula. Okay, now A type particle, you have 1. So you'll be writing A1.
And B-type particles, you have 3. So you'd write B, you'd be writing B3. So you have the molecular formula as AB3. AB3. This would be the molecular formula of the given compound. Isn't it? So this is how you would solve the question. Okay. One more we would be doing. Let's say we have another type of compound where you have the X particle, Y particle and the Z particle. Okay. Let's say you have the X particle there. In that one compound, you have the X particles at corners. Then you have Y particles. Y particles are there at the, you can say, where Y particles are, let's say Y particles are 1 by 3 of the face centers. 1 by 3 of face centers. Means in all the face centers, Y particles are not there. Means out of total, only 1 by 3rd of all the face centers, you have the Y particle there. Okay, now you have to find out the molecular formula. Now, if you see, in case of, you have X particle there at the corners. So, in case of you have X, we have 8 corners and contribution is 1 by 8. So, you will be getting 1. So, X particles are only 1. Now, you would be counting the Y particles there. By Y particle, but Y particles are there only 1 by 3 of the face center. How many faces are there? 6. And out of 6, not in all 6 faces the Y particles are there. Only in 1 by 3rd. So, you would be writing 1 by 3rd of this one. Okay. So, only in this much faces, you would have the Y particle. And contribution in case of the face is how much? 1 by 2. Again, you would be multiplying it by 1 by 2. So, you would be getting the answer. Answer is 1. So, molecular formula will be how much? Molecular formula. X particle 1. So, X1. Y particle also 1. So, Y1. So, answer would be XY. So, this would be the molecular formula of the given compound. Isn't it? Yeah. So, one more question, let me tell you now. Hope you would be getting this now. Okay. Now, let's see. You have X particles now. One more question. You have X particles in the 1 by 3 of end face center. Okay. You have X particles in 1 by 3 of, means you can say edges. 1 by 3 of edges or end face centers. Okay. Let's say, you have 1 by 3 of edges. Okay, means in all the edges you have 12 edges, but X particles are there only 1 by 3 of the edges. Then you have Y particles, and Y particles are there at let's say 1 by 3 of face centers. Then you have Z particles are also there, and the Z particles are there at the body center. Now again you have to find out the molecular formula. Now if you see, you have X particle in 1 by 3 of the edges. 1 by 3 total 12 edges are there. And in case of the edges, the contribution is 1 by 4. So multiply this by 1 by 4 again. So 3, 4, that 12, 4, 4 cutting. Then you'd be getting 1. So X particles are only 1 there. So Y type particle, if you want to find out, these are present in 1 by 3 of the face centers. Total face centers are 6. Out of this, only in 1 by 3 you have the Y particles. And contribution in case of the faces is how much? 1 by 2. So if you are solving this, you'd be getting again 1. Similarly, you have to find out the number of particles, Z particles there. Z particles are present only in the body centers. Now you'll be knowing how many body centers are there. 1. And contribution is again 1. So 1, 1, ja, 1. So if you want to find out the molecular formula, so it would be X1, Y1. Y is only 1 there. And Z1. So X, Y, Z. This would be the molecular formula of the given compound. Isn't it? So this is how you would be solving the given questions related to the molecular formula and how to find out the rank or the number of particles there. So this is all we have discussed here. Then again, we will be moving ahead and we will be discussing some more topics of this one chapter. Till then, stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you. Have a good day.